In this video, I want to show you how to upload and display an Excel spreadsheet on a SharePoint page. Here we have a pretty typical SharePoint site. And the first thing that we want to do is we want to upload the Excel spreadsheet that you'd like to display. So I'll pick on my Documents library. And from there, I'll pick on Upload. Now, of course, the file might already be on your SharePoint site, but in this case, I'm going to upload it. So I'll pick on Choose Files, and I'll go back to this file that's called Chart Example. You can see it's an Excel spreadsheet. And at that point, I'll pick on OK. And now that file is in my Documents library, as you can see. So I'm going to go to the home page here. Now, what I'm about to show you will work on any page within your SharePoint site. Now, of course, you have to have editor rights to the page. I'm going to pick on the word page up here, and I'll pick on edit. Now, you click where you want that Excel spreadsheet to appear, and that could be anywhere, but I'm just going to put it right at the top so it'll be pretty obvious. At this point, we'll pick on Insert, and we'll pick on Web Part. Now, you're going to come over here, and you pick on Business Data, and then you pick on Excel Web Address, or I'm sorry, Excel Web Access. Now, at this point, we'll pick on Add. Now, it's going to say the screen. To display a workbook in this web part, you must first select the workbook. To select the workbook, open the tool pane and then edit the workbook property. Click here to open the tool pane. So we are going to click there. And the tool pane is going to be over on the right hand side, over here. So you're going to pick on the space versus workbook, and you pick on the three dots. And here's the different libraries within your SharePoint site. So I'll go back to my Documents library. And here's the chart example file I just uploaded. So I'm going to click that. Make sure it's outlined in blue like that. And then I'll pick on Insert. Now you can certainly now where it says named item, if that workbook had a range or a sheet that you want to display, you would pick on named item there. So let's see if anything comes up there. I don't know if this workbook has any named ranges, but if it had like named ranges or sheets, they would show up when we would pick on the three dots. I think in this case it may not have any. Okay. Now I'm going to scroll down, and you can try some of these other options. But really, the most important one is going to be the workbook name. In this case, I'm going to click on OK. And if I scroll back to the top of the page, we can now see that the Excel web part is going to be there, as you can see. Now, make sure you save your SharePoint page. So in this case, I'll pick on Page, and I'll pick on Save. Now, when that web page displays, it's going to show the Excel workbook as we can see. Now, somebody can open that from here, or they can do other things to this document as well, right from the right from your SharePoint page. But let's say to get to that document through the Documents library, you're going to see that if we update it in the Documents library, it'll update it on this page as well. So I'll pick on Documents, and let's say somebody checks that document out. There's the chart example. I'm going to go into there. And in this case, I'll come over here and I'll say Edit Workbook. Now you can either edit it in the regular version of Excel or the online version. So here, I just have to make a simple change. I'll say edit in Excel online, if you have that installed. Otherwise, you would download it to a normal Excel. And I want to change this to say 2015, which is when I'm recording this video. And maybe over here, we'll change it to the word sales. All right, and now I'm ready to save that spreadsheet. So by the way, when you're on the online version of Excel, it saves automatically for you. So what we'll do at this point is I'm just gonna go back here. So I'll pick on the PC Guy team site, which is the site I was working with anyway. It really does automatically save that. Now, if I go back to the home page of the site, it's gonna display the Excel spreadsheet with the changes that I just made. And there it is. If I scroll back up, we can see it says 2015, and there it says the word sales. So I showed you how to, first we uploaded the Excel spreadsheet into one of your document libraries. Then from there, I showed you how to put it on the page, on your SharePoint page. And really, if somebody changes that anywhere within your SharePoint, anybody changes that file, then the new version will show up on that page.